Hello everyone, this is Ryan Mitchell from thetinylife.com. I just finished the floor framing and all the tie downs, so I kind of wanted to walk you through what I've done so far. So here's the front head of the trailer, and this was the area that I was kind of going back and forth on how I wanted to approach it, because when I received the trailer, they had installed a pretty beefy I-beam on the front of it that rose above the trailer and kind of hung off towards the rear of it. So it was kind of eating into my framing space that I needed. So what I did is I had the welder take off the top right of the eye of the I-beam, and the manufacturer said that that wouldn't influence any of the structural integrity of the trailer. And from there, I was able to marry these two right front 2x4s, and then I was able to add a 2-inch wide and 1-inch deep piece of wood to kind of fill out the space here. And I'll zoom in. So you could see here on the left is that 2-inch wide, 1-inch deep, and then my two 2x4s. And then you can see the lag bolt on the right sticking out, and that's going through the two 2x4s, through the I-beam, and it's all bolted together to tie in. And there's four of those in the front header there. Then, like I mentioned in my other video, I have these 6 5/8 galvanized thread rods that have been welded on the trailer, and they actually come up through these two 2x4s, which I've put liquid nail between them and then fastened them very securely to basically laminate them together. So the two 2x4s, even though they're separate pieces, are almost acting like one here. So a very strong piece of wood. And then you can see I used corner braces on each cross member, and you can't see them all because they're on the other side, but there's one in each corner on each cross member, and then in each major corner I made sure to put corner braces to add the rigidity to that space. So now, looking at the overall framing, the way that I approach this is basically three separate sections, essentially three squares. You have the forward part, you have the center part between the wheel wells, and you have the rear part. And you'll notice the forward and the middle have floor joists that are going side to side, while the rear one lengthwise. And the reason why that is because that square or that section is hanging off the back, and so the forces are a lot different than the other two squares. Even though they have supports and they'll be anchored down there, it's just another step. You can see here is the wheel well, and I had to frame around that, and that was a little tricky, and I left about a 1/4-inch gap, which you can see pretty good here. We'll zoom in. So you can see that 1/4-inch gap. And what I did is I used a carpenter's pencil, or a couple of them, and I just taped them to the wheel well, and that was my spacer, which is about a 1/4-inch, 1/3-inch. But it gave me a uniform spacer for each side of this. And then you can see all my brackets there. All right, so we're up closer towards the wheel well, and I wanted to show you guys the joint that I made here. And I did this for some extra strength, where I chiseled out a section so it was kind of nested within that 2x4 there, which you can see right here. And these two here are liquid nailed and then fastened with fasteners to basically create one solid beam. And then I had nails driving through here the whole length, and then I also did a corner brace down here. And you can also see right there between the wheel well, I kind of gave a gap, again, that quarter inch or so from the carpenter's pencils. And one thing I wanted to note is these cross joists, the floor joists here, they're going across left to right, aren't just placed kind of randomly. They're actually spaced so that as I'm laying my subflooring, the plywood on top of this, they're going to be at 2 foot increments. So I know exactly where to screw the subflooring down into without having to guess or miss the studs. I know exactly where, because they're all at 2 foot increments.